Hey there, I'm Catherine.
And I'm Sammy.
And we are educators here at the Perot Museum. And we love doing science experiments today. We have a really cool experiment.
So we're studying the atmosphere. So hopefully you've already seen our experiment last where we created a cloud. And we ended that experiment by talking about why do all clouds not precipitate? Some of them do and some of them don't. And we're actually gonna show you guys why that is. The variable that affects whether or not a cloud is going to precipitate or not is actually not temperature, but pressure. So pressure is just how tight the atmosphere is squeezing onto something at a certain time. So Catherine and everybody at home, go ahead and give yourself a really big, tight squeeze, a big hug. So as you're doing that, try to take a deep breath in. Fill your lungs. It's probably not very easy to do that because you're putting yourself under high pressure. So clouds under high pressure can't really grow big and tall like the clouds that we see right before a rainstorm. But under low pressure, once we, you know, came out of our tight hug, now we can take a deep breath, fill our lungs up and have them grow big and tall, just like clouds in the atmosphere. So low pressure allows clouds to grow, condense more water droplets, and become heavier and heavier, eventually to where that water is going to fall out. So following back to our water cycle, we call that precipitation. And that can be in a lot of different forms. We've got
rain,
snow,
hail,
and sleet. All right, so we're gonna model what happens to clouds out in the atmosphere with some clouds that we have here.
Marshmallows.
Awesome, thank you.
Now, our experiment today, we don't eat our science experiments.
You're right.
I know we can find these definitely in our kitchen pantries, but today, they're gonna be clouds, so imagine with us. Now, for our experiment today, we're using something called a vacuum chamber. Now, I have a glass jar right here, and this connects to this platform. When I turn on our machine, it's gonna start taking air away. So it's gonna start sucking the air out from inside of this jar, and what that does is we're lowering the pressure. So if we go ahead and put our cloud inside of our jar, and we're gonna turn it on, we're gonna see what happens when we lower the pressure on our cloud.
So remember, your hug, right? High pressure, you can't grow big and tall. Low pressure, let's see what happens.
All right, we're gonna turn this on and let's see what happens.
Awesome.
So we saw under low pressure, as less air was in that jar, the marshmallows started to grow. Now, eventually, all the air has left inside of this jar and the marshmallow stops growing. That's when I turned it off. But did you notice how when I let the air back in, the marshmallow actually changed texture and shrunk back down? That's because we were putting high pressure. We were allowing all that air that originally left come back in and exerted high pressure on our cloud.
So a really cool thing that you guys can actually do at home to experiment when pressure changes outside in our atmosphere is by creating your own barometer. A barometer is a tool that is sensitive to pressure changes. And it might not look very fancy here, but hopefully you guys have all of the tools at home and we'll walk you through in our next video how to make one of these yourself. Bye.